just did our second plant bath. I don't have that much on me, like, oh, protection of the heart. What? I think so. That's awesome to me. I guess my heart is meant to be protected today. I am feeling a little bit nervous for the ceremony because I'm gonna go deeper with my intention to really confront the things that are no longer serving me. But I'm ready. I'm pretty much ready. I'm ready for it to happen. What I'm wearing tonight is these ayahuasca pants that I just bought from the tribe next door. They're called Libertad. Tribe of Freedom, of Liberty. Come on. The resonance? I know you know. Anyways, yeah, I'm gonna wear those pants and probably my white tank. I wanna try and keep like light colors while I'm in ceremony, but that's probably gonna die out by the end of this week unless I rewear them. That's where I'm at. And I'll be back once I'm changed.
The perfect time to record.
Outfit first day two ceremony. Meet ayahuasca.
Me too. I'm gonna wear this. I'm looking for my sports bra with my pink.
Another eye of ordinary woman lives her own being, but lives in part of me. All I could hear is her struggling to speak. All I heard, someone took her voice. Someone took her voice. And the amount of fear and the one she loved, herself, trying to speak out.
So you can see here, I look very exhausted, and I was sobbing my eyes out during my ceremony last night, and my eyes are swollen, and I was really just at a loss for words of what I really experienced. Majority of the morning, I just laid down and rested outside. I was completely exhausted from last night's ceremony. You know, I had the nerves of what my second ceremony, what would come up, and my Mother Aya gave me exactly what I asked for, and there was no fear. It was just a lot of grief and a lot of pain that was buried within me, and she showed me this fragment of myself that was ultimately neglected. And even though last night's ceremony was so challenging, I felt this deep state of gratitude to be working with Mother Aya and to be in the Amazon doing the work that I've always felt called to.
This is a song for anyone with a broken heart. This is a song for anyone who can't get out of bed. I'll do anything to be happy.
So, first ceremony was amazing. I won't even say the second ceremony was amazing, just for making it out alive. Very intense. The lack of control, as well as... I don't know. Not being able to tell or say that I need help. Like, basically a woman came to me, and she said, she spoke in my mind, and said someone took my voice, and she's just so hurt. She's been betrayed by so many people that she loved. Honestly, it's something that stuck on me because I don't want to know who took her voice. I want to know who she is. I also feel like she's a part of me because I could relate to her. But man, her pain was like, oof. I just wonder, like, is that what I'm running from? I started journaling and I couldn't go finish it. I'm going to try. But I couldn't finish it. I really couldn't. I'm so exhausted. After group share, I laid down and, I laid down.
It took me some time to really think over if I wanted to share these deep personal moments with the internet world, but a part of this healing that I'm going through, I felt called to.
Yeah. When I went to go lay down, I couldn't go to sleep right away, but when I woke up, it was 1 o'clock. And, I was like, I just want to wash my face and wet my hair and redo it. I'm not struggling or anything, but I'm just still feel the feelings, you know?
Majority of that morning / day, I was pretty quiet and to myself. And it was ultimately because I felt like lifetimes worth of pain in just one sitting. And there was no way to completely just, you know, I don't know. There was no way to jump back in to life like, okay, I had this experience, what's next? I felt like I needed to really integrate it. And maybe integration is not the best term to use because integration is something that I'm still experiencing with my ceremonies that happened over a month ago already. I just think that after such a psychedelic experience at that, there's this certain time span of processing the experience and really sitting with, okay, this happened. This happened.
We did a rapé early in the morning. But
the Shipibo tribe do it differently, where
clearly I became too focused on my hair and I couldn't form a sentence because the focus was just so intensely making sure I got my hair laid and slayed. As I was saying prior to before, the Shipibo tribe do rape differently, where rather than snorting the powder of this tobacco, they put it into a form of a liquid. And what the lead shaman, Maestra Justina, does, she mixes the rape with the agua florida, and she has a little spoon and she pours it up your nostrils. And I can say the experience wasn't bad, but yeah, just imagine having some strong tobacco poured up your nose with Florida water. So at the retreat at Arcana in the Amazon, there's a few malokas. The big maloka is for ceremonial. And in this room, this is called the Choloka, and it's where people can come to read. The Wi-Fi is here. It's pretty relaxing, and it's ultimately beautiful because of the outside view with the hammocks. Although I wasn't able to document all that I wanted to and say all I wanted to in my video recordings, I made sure to document everything in my journal when I had the chance, especially the ceremonies I experienced, because they say that, you know, you're doing 10% of the work by drinking the medicine. The rest of the work is really done once you leave. And almost going on 2 months now, I definitely see that. And I see some hidden themes within my ceremonies popping up. And, you know, I believe as time progresses, the ceremonies will make more and more sense. I ended up doing the Sapo ceremony, and it was amazing. I say that now that I'm out of it, but I was crying a lot. Anyways, ayahuasca's tonight, so I love you. I'll talk to you tomorrow.
No, I know. I'm cutting it off. But not entirely. I did not want to bore you guys with a long freaking video. So part two is going to be uploaded probably after this one, so go check it out. If you've gotten this far, thank you for tuning in. Thank you for listening to me share this journey of my experience with plant medicine and my healing through it, I thought. Second video is going to be about Aya Ceremony 3 and me diving deep and what happened. And it gets deep. Deeply intense, I guess I can say. If I had to put a scale between Aya Ceremony 2 and this third one, I couldn't. It just is. Go check it out. See what the hell happened. And yeah, as always, grateful for you guys tuning in, and much love. Always.